Welcome to part 5 of this series of introductory video presentations on an introduction to Open Data Kit, a learning resource compiled by Statistics for Sustainable Development for researchers, students, or anyone else who may be interested in learning the fundamentals of ODK and mobile data collection. This section today shall focus on using Kobo Toolbox as your ODK aggregator, though many of the steps are similar, if not the same, if other aggregators such as Honor are used instead. Particularly, the steps involving ODK collect will be the same regardless of whichever ODK aggregator you use. This tutorial will be using the example XLS form discussed in the previous three presentations, though alternatively, you could create your own account and use your own XLS form along with the steps outlined in this presentation. The decision is entirely yours. As for the contents of today's presentation, I'll begin by looking a little bit more into ODK aggregators as a general topic, before looking specifically into Kobo Toolbox, beginning with how to create an account, and then how to upload a form to Kobo. With this section, many of the steps are similar in other ODK aggregators, such as Honor. And then finally, a little bit more into settings, specifically regarding your project and your form. Now, if you cast your mind back to the first presentation in this series, you'll remember that we explored ODK as transitioning from a paper survey to your computer by creating an XLS form, and then from your computer to the ODK aggregator by uploading said form, and then moving to your mobile device by downloading the form itself, ready for data collection, then uploading your data back up to the aggregator before finally downloading your data onto your computer. Now, we have already seen in the previous three presentations this first step of moving from paper to digital by creating an XLS form. This presentation will explore in more depth the next step of uploading your form to an ODK aggregator, and then a little bit on dealing with the ODK aggregator itself. In the next section, we will be looking closer at steps 3 and 4. Firstly, let's remind ourselves of exactly what an ODK aggregator is. An ODK aggregator is the server which will store your forms and your data. The usual process is that you will upload your form and create a project for this form. You'll then download forms from this server to mobile devices for data collection, upload your data to the server and monitor submissions, and finally download your data. As mentioned in part 1, there are a number of aggregators, including Kobo, Honor, and FormHub. This part shall focus mainly on Kobo Toolbox, but many of the principles are transferable, and most servers operate in similar ways and will allow you to do similar things, such as the data monitoring, setting projects, upload media files, which are integral to your forms, and many more things. As previously mentioned, this set of videos will focus on the use of Kobo Toolbox as your aggregator. We found at kobotoolbox.org. And now, if you go onto that site, with this being the homepage, if you scroll down to this Get Started section, this is where you'll be able to log in or create your own account if you have not done already. If you are creating your account for the first time, you can ignore the Unlimited Use for Humanitarian Organizations section, as this does not apply to us. Instead, focus on the researchers, aid workers, and everybody else section. If you go through onto this, you'll be able to provide your name, username, email address, and a password to create your own account, as well as some other optional details that you do not have to provide. Now, it is crucial to remember this username and password, as you will need this when you're collecting data, as you need to connect your mobile data collection app to this server using these login details. Now, for this specific project, I have created a specific account with an example XLS form, although you are encouraged to follow these steps so that you can create your own project with your own account, possibly using your own form if you so wish, although you are allowed to use the example one provided. I recommend using your own in order to get a better understanding of some of the key steps and the data monitoring aspects of Kobo, which we shall explore. So just to remind you, use this section and then create your own account by filling in all these details, remembering your username and password because you will need them to connect to the server. Once you have created and activated your own account by replying to the activation email, your first step will create a new project, so that you can upload your form and begin collecting data. process for creating a project is very similar when using Honor or any other ODK aggregator. Firstly, you would have to create a new project by clicking New. If I show you the website, I'll be able to show you this in more detail. When you log on to Kobo, this is its home page. You'll see I already have one project here in the beginning, SSD Introduction to ODK, which has already been employed and has 10 submissions. And of course, we'll want to create a new project by clicking on New, where I'll be given prompts for how to include my first form for this project. I could either build it from scratch, use a template, import via URL, or directly upload an XLS form. As mentioned, when you start your own project, you'll be immediately shown this screen asking you to choose a source for your form. It is recommended that you first create your form in Excel and then upload it using this link. This is the best way to have full control over what you include in your form, as it is much more flexible when you are manually creating it in Excel, as opposed to, for example, using one of these dedicated form builder tools, as these are often a little less malleable with what you can achieve in them, especially when it comes to media files. Alternatively, you could use one of their templates, but again, this is not as flexible as entirely designing your own form. Crucially, when you are making your own form in Excel, be sure to save it as a .xls or a .xlsx spreadsheet, as this is the file formats that work when the aggregator turns your Excel file into an XLS form file specifically. When you're using another ODK aggregator, these tools are very much the same, especially in Honor. They provide you with the same four options for uploading your form. Now, once you have done this on the website, you'll be shown this box where you'll be able to give your project a name, a description, suggest which sector and which country the project belongs to. So once you've done this, you can press Create Project. And what's shown here is the project page for your project, where everything will be stored, where you can look at all your data and create all your settings for your project. And specifically, it already has your form uploaded, but not yet deployed, ready for data collection. Once you have uploaded your form, you can post it to the server by pressing the deploy button on the right within that draft version box. Once you have done this, this is when you'll be able to download your form to a mobile device. If you are using other aggregators, some deploy them automatically and do not require this step. Going back to the website, you'll see we have the deploy button here on the right. And if I press this, it should now upload this form ready for data collection. This can now be downloaded by mobile devices. Now, also from this page, you will also be able to edit your form, preview your form, replace it. And using this part down here, you can set how this project allows data submissions, whether it can do online, offline, or through mobile devices, etc. But also if you go to the settings tab, you can set other settings, including changing the name of your project, entering a description, or even deleting the project and your data if need be. Now, from this page, if you go onto media, you will also be able to upload media files such as CSVs or image files, including JPEGs, which are in some way needed for your formal project. Now, there are many reasons why you may wish to do this. For example, you may require some data to be inputted from a separate file for some sort of data validation or filling long choice lists, or perhaps your study is a follow-up and you are interviewing the same people from a previous survey, in which case you can upload the CSV using the results from the previous survey to be used in some way within your form. Perhaps bring in these variables to be checked or updated in some way, or to get new values which are more up to date. But also, in terms of uploading pictures or audio files, this could be because they are required as answer choices for a question. For example, you can have a multiple choice answer question where the answers are actually images. So, just to summarize what we've done here today, be sure to choose the ODK aggregator which best suits your needs. Other options besides Kobo Toolbox, which I have shown here today, are available and may be better suited for your project. For instance, Honor can host many more projects and more daily submissions. However, these versions are not free and be quite expensive depending on your resources. So be sure to take account of what resources you have available and what the needs of your project are to make the best decision. Once you have decided, you can upload your XLS form and create a project. This will keep all your forms, media files, and your data all together in one convenient place. Finally, be sure to remember your username and password for this ODK aggregator, as you will need it for data collection. This is because data collection apps need these login details to be able to connect to the server so you can download your forms and upload your data afterwards. That's it for part 5. And in part 6, I'll be looking specifically at collecting data using your forms on mobile devices, specifically using the app known as ODK Collect, which is the open source ODK app for collecting data. And it is optimized for Android devices. It does work with others, but it is best to use an Android device when collecting data of this type. Thank you for listening, and I shall see you in part 6.